Investigations. After you have narrowed down your focus in the history and examination by thinking of probable diseases and excluding the unlikely causes, you could advise certain investigations for the patient if need be. Remember, it is good clinical practice to avoid unnecessary investigations. Common investigations in fever include complete blood count, the white cell count is raised in cases of infection, liver function test, urine routine examination, chest x-ray. Some diseases are common in certain areas, so investigations for them could be included. In other words, PPD test for tuberculosis and viral antibodies for hepatitis. Cultures for urine, sputum, blood, or pus may be needed in cases of bacterial infection to identify the specific pathogen. Red flags. Although a multitude of conditions can cause fever, as mentioned before, but some conditions are more serious than others and require special attention. Always pay special heed to cases of fever with one of the following. 1. Neck stiffness, low GCS or acute neurological deficits. 2. Severe chest pain. 3. Rapid weight loss. 4. Patient with toxic look. 5. Respiratory distress. 6. History of any recent surgical procedure. 7. Patient who is immunocompromised. 8. High-risk behavior, including drugs and sexual promiscuity. 9. History of travel to an endemic area. And 10. If no obvious cause is found for the fever within 3 weeks, in the last case scenario, it becomes known as pyrexia of unknown origin and requires extensive workup. Febrile seizures. Some children aged 6 months to 5 years may also have associated seizures with an episode of fever. This may greatly worry the patients and their parents, but they should be reassured that febrile seizures are mostly harmless and do not damage the brain. In case the febrile seizures are not being controlled, refer to pediatricians. Treatment. Definitive treatment of the fever lies in treating the underlying cause. In most cases, it is an infection, so the proper antimicrobial drugs should be prescribed. Warning. Do not use antibiotics without proper prescription, or use less than the prescribed period, as this leads to antibiotic resistance resulting in tougher infections. For symptomatic relief of fever, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, in other words, ibuprofen or paracetamol, may be used. These provide only temporary relief from fever. Please note that no medications are free from side effects, and it is better to avoid taking any medication without any valid reason.